Hello! This beer comes from Mr. Simon Seaton, Leeds lad, outside of Wakefield. It is Princess LuLu. It's a Belgian strong pale ale. I put the link to his recipe and the technique down in the description bar. Well, yeah, thanks again, Simon Seaton from Armchair Brewery. Slight fizz. Or checking up on the Untapped on the Google thing, search engine. And basically, on his pictures, he used a Leffe glass, so out of respect to Simon Seaton. This is AG34. 21 IBU at 8.1%, so it's a big boy beer. So it's gonna pour. Very fizzy. Right. I was gonna use my Devel glass, but early in the week when I were on wash up, it kind of got broken. So. And all the other developed glasses I give to the charity shop, and the only one in cellar I have left is for my collection, beer glass collection. Pour in a sandy yellow colour. Definitely get that Belgian aroma, that yeast strain. Slight bit of sweetener there. A little peach, maybe an apricot. A little bit of citrusy lime. A little bit of Yorkshire pudding. Not to self, put it down please, that's what's going on. Definitely a little bit of pancake taste, which you would normally get from a Belgian light ale. Here we go. Pour a little bit. A bit more. Because it's bottle conditioned. And put it into resting from the photo later. But yeah, it's cool that, again, I've said this a number of times, that it's cool that it's labeled all finished now for his beers. It just shows that he's one step closer to becoming a professional brewer. I know Mr. Kevin Black's had Simon's beers and a few other home brewers also via Black Country Homebrew Club, Jim's Beer Kit, Doncaster Homebrew, Homebrew Corner. What's it? I'm forgetting some, but it's a little bit of a peach colour to it, a little sunblush orange. Definitely get those amaretto biscuits. A little bit of orange cordial. Definitely orange cordial in the taste. A little bit of amaretto biscuit. That's lovely. Don't get the ABV. It's slightly chilled. It's been in my cellar for a while. I wanted to save this till almost last, because I want to have his porter last. But I had a homebrew Belgian style before, I don't think so. It's still missing somebody, but not somebody, but some body to the beer. Because it starts off really nice and then it just wavers. And then it has a nice sweet but crisp, like brandy snaps at the end. Well, that's a nice beer, nonetheless. Thanks again, Simon Seaton. And if you're thinking about homebrewing and you're watching this video, check out places like Homebrew on the Green and other homebrew shops in your local area. I know Wilko's and certain other outlets now stock homebrew supplies. My brother's now an homebrewer. Yeah, if you've got the time and you want to put your little etch in the beer, give it a little go. Thanks again, Simon Seaton. And check out the homebrew clubs on the Facebook. You take care.